Holla. Hey guys, in today's video, we're gonna cover engine break-in procedure. Whether you have a built motor, maybe you've assembled at home by yourself, or you bought an engine from MAPerformance or any of the other reputable brands out there that sell you an engine, there's specific ways that you're gonna wanna break that motor in to make sure that you maximize the longevity of that engine and that you're just gonna want to be safe, right? A lot of times people don't think of things when they go to do their first startup, like checking for fuel leaks or oil leaks. In today's video, we're gonna cover the 7 steps that our engine building experts have decided you need to know about as you go into not only the first startup on your built engine, but also on the break-in procedure. And we're gonna cover everything today, so stay tuned. So the first thing we wanna touch on with everyone is safety. Whether you built the motor yourself, or maybe you've had it assembled at a shop, or your friends came over and helped you assemble it, you need to double check everything. That goes for bolts, make sure everything's tight. You're gonna wanna make sure your timing, depending on your motor, is set. You're gonna wanna go ahead and make sure that all of your fluids, not just your oil, also your coolant, your fuel, make sure everything is tight and tidy. If you guys have any oil leaks, any fuel leaks, maybe you don't have coolant in the engine, those are all things that are gonna be a severe hindrance when you go to start this and go through this break-in procedure. Outside of just being safe and making sure you've double-checked all the work you've done to the motor before starting it up, it's also important to be safe in regards to the fluid you're putting in there. During that first startup, we recommend using an inexpensive conventional oil. The reason we haven't switched over to using like a break-in oil or something like that is conventional oil is a lot cheaper. This oil is really going through kind of that first heat up, that first 20 minutes where you're varying the RPM range. And the main purpose of this is to kind of clean out that engine. We're gonna be draining that oil after that first 20 minutes of startup anyways, and moving over to a break-in oil during our first 500 miles worth of break-in. So definitely keep that in mind. Make sure you've got some cheap conventional oil on hand to prime the system, and then for that first startup and first 20 minutes of running your new motor. So once you've done all your safety checks, you made sure your fluids are good and that your bolts are tight, the final thing you need to do is go ahead and secure that vehicle, lock it into place by setting the e-brake or putting some wheel chocks into place, because what we're gonna do is we're gonna prime the vehicle. Big things to consider here is to make sure you haven't connected your fuel. We definitely don't want fuel going in the cylinders at this point. Additionally, what we don't want is we don't want the crank position sensor to be connected as of yet. So if you've taken any of those steps, make sure you undo them before we prime the motor. What we're gonna do to prime it, you're just gonna get in the car with those things disconnected. You're gonna turn the key over until the oil light on the dash goes away. That's gonna tell you that the oil's been running through the system and that you're okay to go ahead and connect those things before first startup. So we got safety, we primed the motor, and the next big thing you're gonna do is start this engine. I know a lot of you guys are very excited for this piece, so make sure you listen to what we're about to talk about. During that first startup, it's important, it's vital, it's extremely important, guys, hear me out here, that you monitor your oil pressure during this period. That first startup, if you notice a low oil pressure, low oil volume, sensor light of anything coming on, you're gonna wanna make sure you instantly shut that motor off. That's gonna give you a big red flag to say that there's a catastrophic issue with the bottom end of your motor. The more diligent you can be with watching those gauges and monitoring your oiling system during this process, you are gonna save yourself a lot of headache if something was assembled wrong or you do have a problem. The sooner you shut that off, the better. After that engine is turned over and after you get that first click and the thing fires up, what we do and how our engine break-in procedure is laid out is that you're gonna wanna run that engine for about 20 minutes. Not just idling, we're definitely not looking to idle this, guys. We need to actually slowly ramp that RPM up between 2,000 to 3,000, and you need to vary the RPMs in between that range to start to really get those rings to seal. It's going to allow for the lifters to break in, especially on certain applications such as the Evo 10 or some of the Subarus with the flat tappet style. You're gonna wanna make sure that there's at least 20 minutes of break in with that varying RPM. It's gonna seal the rings really well against that fresh cross-hatching from honing, and you're just gonna end up with a motor that lasts you a lot longer and really performs better. It doesn't burn as much oil. So it's very important, guys. Take some time, get that first startup right, and make sure that you run this car appropriately and spend time varying your RPMs to give this a good break-in on your brand new engine. During the first 20 minutes of runtime on your new engine, you're gonna wanna have an extra set of hands there, maybe a friend or a family member that can watch things with you. We're gonna wanna be checking for oil leaks or coolant leaks. You're gonna wanna make sure you watch your air fuel ratios and make sure nothing's too lean or too rich. But during that time, you're definitely gonna wanna keep a close eye on things as we vary those RPMs between 2,000 and 3,000. Once you're done with about 20 minutes of runtime on that, you've heat cycled everything, we're gonna wanna go ahead and get rid of that cheap, inexpensive, conventional oil out of your system. So make sure you drain it while the car is still relatively warm. That helps make sure that the oil runs smooth and that we get all the contaminants out. And at that point, we're gonna be switching over to our engine break-in oil. We highly recommend like Lucas Oil or some of the other high zinc oils out there that are specifically meant for engine break-in for this next step. Now that we've checked our safety, we double checked our bolts, fluids, we moved on to priming the engine, and that was really not much fun, but then we started it. Now the thing's running, we got 20 minutes of varying RPMs between 2,000 and 3,000 RPMs. We've got this thing broken in. The next step many of you are gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna take this car on the road. That is the most exciting point, and that's generally where excitement can trump smarts. You guys need to be thinking when you're doing this, just like earlier on in the process. As you get into that car and you take it for the first cruise, what we recommend is you're gonna take that car and you're gonna go drive for about 30 to 50 miles. You're gonna vary your speeds, and you're gonna do that under light load conditions. What we mean is no wide open throttle. You are going to slowly accelerate to speed. What you're gonna do after you get up to speed is you are going to let the engine break you down. These are called vacuum pulls. Pretty simple to do. You slowly accelerate to speed and you let the engine go ahead and be used as an engine brake to slow you back down. That is what is putting pressure against the piston rings, against the cylinder wall, and really seating those piston rings well and creating the nice seal that you guys are looking for to make sure that we're not having any oil burning or oil usage in the future with this new built motor. Pretty simple, but it definitely makes a big difference, and it's something that you guys are gonna wanna do. Whether you do this alone or with a friend, that's up to you, but you do also wanna make sure while you're doing this, that speed up, slow down, you're still monitoring all those vital things, water temperature, oil pressure, that sort of stuff, to make sure that there's nothing going wrong with the rest of your systems. Many people that have built a motor generally will talk to their tuner and they'll get kind of what's considered a base map or kind of a limp map to allow them to start the car, to potentially break in the car, and then even some cases to limp it to the dyno if they choose not to trailer it. There's some things you're gonna need to consider there, and this is again where it's very important to monitor those vitals. If you guys are watching things like oil pressure, oil temp, and you're not watching air fuel, you could run into problems. Whether it's lean or rich, can cause catastrophic and unrepairable damage to that brand new engine you just put in your car. So make sure you keep an eye on your air fuel ratios throughout the entirety of this break-in process. Congratulations, we have a successful maiden voyage. You guys have made it home. You drove 30 to 50 miles, you varied your engine speed, you did a lot of those vacuum pulls to really seat those engine rings. The big thing you need to do now is change the oil. What we're gonna be doing here is we're pulling that engine oil out. We're gonna be inspecting that oil. We're looking for things like contaminants, maybe metal shrapnel in there. You're also gonna wanna do that same thing with the oil filter. It's a huge opportunity for you guys to catch things early on and potentially prevent big issues that may come in the future. After you've drained that break-in oil, what we're gonna go ahead and do is replace it with more break-in oil. We still wanna keep that high quality break-in oil in this motor with that high zinc content to really make everything seal and to give you the best longevity and performance out of your motor. Once you've done that at the 30 to 50 mile range, you got in your garage, you drained it, you replaced it, we're gonna run that break-in oil this time up to about 500 miles. And that is your first oil change where you will go ahead and switch over to synthetic or whatever oil you want to run in that car as you move forward. At 500 miles, that's where we consider your engine fully broken in. You've primed it, you're safe, you primed it, you started it, you heat cycled it, you ran a couple miles, you drained some oil, you ran up to 500 miles, you drained the oil again. Now go ahead and put whatever oil you want in it. Take it to your tuner, take it to the racetrack, put it through its paces. At this point, if you followed all the steps I've given you today, you should have a really healthy engine on your hands that should be able to take anything you can throw at it. Bonus pro tip for you guys, make sure that if you're reusing any parts from a previous engine, whether it be internal parts or even such things as a cylinder head or an oil cooler kit, that you properly clean those before you put them on a new motor. There's no easier way to destroy this huge investment you just made than to put on an oil cooler that has shrapnel in it, or to reuse a cylinder head that is warped or damaged. Those things we see quite commonly, especially because we sell a lot of these short blocks. We find at-home mechanics putting on used parts that have not been properly prepared to be bolted onto a new engine. Bonus tip. For those of you that are getting a fully forged motor, you guys are building a motor for the first time, or maybe this is your first time owning a built motor, there's definitely a lot of considerations you want to make. They're not going to run exactly like an OEM motor. They're going to be built with the purpose in mind. So when we build an engine, it may have a little bit looser tolerances than a factory engine. A lot of people will really see that in the symptoms of maybe more oil usage than what they had with their factory motor. Potentially even more noise coming from that engine than they had with their factory motor. Those are things you're gonna wanna talk with us about, or whoever you choose to be your engine builder. There's definitely a lot of variables that play into that. And depending on how you're gonna use that motor, thinking ahead and talking with the engine builder to give them that insight will result in a better end product for you, because all of these gaps, any of the clearances that are in this motor, are blueprinted and done by hand by a trained professional if you're buying from us, and they can vary those tolerances in the way that that's built, and they suit it to your needs and your desires from your car. So make sure those are things you're aware of when you first get a built motor, so that you don't just go online and start saying my motor's loud or it's using oil. Think about those things. It's a race engine, treat it like a race engine, and be prepared to deal with some of the downsides to owning a race engine in your car. Guys, I'm really happy to have shared this knowledge with you. Obviously, you can go ahead and go to our website. You can download our complete engine break-in checklist for yourself as well. Hopefully you enjoyed today's content. Go ahead and leave a comment below. Give me your experiences that you've had with breaking in motors. Maybe I'll even share some of my own. I got a few funny stories from the first time I built an engine where I actually put assembly lube on the outside of the main bearings rather than on the inside journals of the main bearing. Feel free to pick on me in the comments below. Thanks for watching, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed today's video.